Hi guys, answering all your questions that you've been asking me for the past few weeks, months together, but repeatedly the same thing about which paints I use for my watercolors, the brand, and the same with the brushes and the papers that I use for my watercolor paintings. So here it is. I hope you enjoy it. You'll have a very detailed tour of all the art supplies related to my watercolors in this video. The first one is obviously the camel, which has been like the basic color set that I got initially even when I was a kid. This is something that I used to use. I had a much smaller set, but now we also have these 18 color set, 24 color set and 36 color sets in Camel Artist watercolors. The texture is smooth and good enough for beginners and for professionals as well. So you can see the colors here, and you can also see the texture it has. It's very easy to use. You just need to get a decent size palette and you can start working with it. And this is something I would suggest all beginners to go with. Don't have to go anything fancy and you're good. The next one is from Mary's. This is something I just randomly came across at a local art supply store and I bought it. I'm not really very happy with this one because I put it into a palette. It is definitely not the same as it was when I first used it. You can see how they become dry. The color is completely dry and it's become into small pieces. And even if I try to add some water and try to work it out, the vibrancy is not the same. You can see how it looks right now. Not great at all. This one's my first Winsor & Newton watercolor set. It's a Cotman pocket-friendly little watercolor set which has 16 colors in it. I really love the colors. It came with a small pencil and a little brush. Also has this little palette on the other side. You can see the colors here. They're really cute and absolute favorite for me while I'm traveling. I would, even though I'm going to paint or not paint, I'm just going to carry this anyway in my bag. And it has this little holder at the back of it, so it's easy to carry around and hold it. Yeah, it's amazing. It's the best I have so far. And this one here is my second watercolor set from Winsor & Newton. I think it has 48 colors. I really don't remember because it's been really long that I bought this. I didn't really get this here in India, but I think I brought it while I was traveling because my city didn't have any of this and I bought it really long time ago. And this is something I've been using for my big art projects, which I plan to like make a good collection of. And as you can see, the colors are already worn out, like they're completely gone. I have to probably like order for them individually, like the little colors. If you can see, the color is completely empty here. And this has been an amazing watercolor set for me, and this is my personal favorite so far. Of all the watercolors that I've used so far, this is my number one go-to watercolor sets. This one here is a recent. It's my recent buy. I bought it about a couple of months back. And it's probably the most expensive watercolor set I have so far. It's Watercolor Gold Class Mission paint set. It's for professionals. And the reason I got is this color. As you can see, the beautiful green. Not just this one green, but there's so many other colors, like in the pinks and blues and yellows, that have such amazing, beautiful, bright tones. I really wanted to try them out. I heard so much about them online and I really didn't like see like why not. I had a good deal on Amazon and I grabbed it. You can see how the packaging is. It has this beautiful classy gold tubes over here. And I am yet to experiment with these colors and do a lot more painting with it. I also bought this Presto Artist painting palette for my Michelot watercolor set so I can use it as its palette, because the bulletproof one was very expensive, the one that is under the brand name of Michelot, the palette that is. And this comes with 36 or 34 wells. I think one well was, I mean, it was falling short of one particular color, and with a palette. And it was pretty good. It was pretty decent so far. I have no issues with it. You can see how vibrant the colors are here on the palette. That's it. This one's my only watercolor pencil set that I have, and it was a present. I got this really long ago, probably 5-6 years back, I guess, way before I took up my profession even more seriously, and I barely used it. It's brand new even now. You can see how the pencil points are, like, they're still the same, the height is the same of the pencil, like, it's absolutely new. And I tried using it a couple of times, but I didn't dare to use it later on. Yeah, it's kind of like a treasure over here. And these here are my favorite watercolor metallic paints. This one's from Prima Marketing Include. It's called Metallic Accents. And I think I did a complete review of this on my Insta stories when I first bought this. I did a detailed review of each and every color available on this palette. The colors are beautiful. Although they are shimmery watercolor paints, the texture is very creamy and the colors look beautiful on a black paper. You can use it for calligraphy. Look at that color. It looks amazing, and I think these are my favorite watercolor metallic paints so far that I've used. If you are into calligraphy and like water-soluble inks, you should definitely give this a try. It's Metallic Semi-Watercolor Cakes. And this next one is from Feindeck. It's a German-based brand. I have a complete video of this particular one. There's a review available on my channel. You guys should check this out if you are interested in this. The next one here is Ecoline Royal Talents brush pens. I bought them in my recent travel. They were just newly put up in the market, and I grabbed the primary color set, which is basically yellow, red and blue. It also has a black color brush pen along with a white color one, which is actually a blender. I've used it mostly for my calligraphy, and it really works well, and I've seen a lot of artists using it for their main watercolor paintings as well. If you like brush pens, you could probably try this one. It's a really good one. This here is again from Royal Talents. I'm pretty sure I didn't buy this here in India, and probably picked it up from one of my travels, and I don't know when and where exactly, but it's just recently I realized they're from Royal Talents and a brand that is used by a lot of professional watercolor artists, and I really want to try this one. I'll probably do, but I don't know when. I hope they're as good as it is talked about by other artists. So yeah. These are a few of my brushes that I use very often. I don't use all of them. I probably use 2 or 3 from this lot, and the rest I use mostly because of a particular project and the requirement that is there. Let it be for acrylics, for a wall painting, for oil on canvas, things like that. But the current brushes that you're seeing are the ones that I'm using more often at the moment because of watercolors. I've been doing a lot of watercolor paintings of late, and these are the brushes that I'm frequently using. This one's from Dalaroni. It's my first expensive watercolor brush, I think. I really didn't like it in the beginning, but later on I started using it for broad washes and like washes on the paper, watercolor paper, and it started working really well. This one is from Rafael. I bought this when I went to Spain. I really love this one. This is my favorite of all because with this I can even do like a very thin line to a nice broad wash with this one. This is absolute favorite of mine. This one's a water brush from Pentel. I use this mostly during my travels. It's easy to use, and well, I don't think many people like it, but I think it's best for traveling purpose. This one's from Da Vinci. I bought this in my recent travels again, and I use these for more of my detailed ones. This is Bianio's watercolor brush. I bought this in my local stationery store, and this is something I've been using from the past 5-6 years. This one again is also from Bianio. I think these two are the most old brushes I have, which are still in use for me. This one particularly I'm using for my acrylic paints, for my wall paintings and acrylic stuff. And this here is a rigger. It's a watercolor brush, but the hair in this one is longer than the regular watercolor brush. You can use this for your calligraphy and also for your watercolor painting. So this is with my brushes. This one's a mechanical pencil, which I took from my father, a kneaded eraser. This is all I use. I don't use anything fancy. It's a very old mechanical pencil. It's probably 10 years old. I've been using it for so long. I don't even remember when I started using it. And this little kneaded eraser to go with anything. These are all my watercolor papers and journals I have so far. This one here is by Fabriano. I bought this in Spain to make postcards for you guys, which I sent you early this summer. Beautiful quality paper. It's 300 GSM watercolor postcards. Art Spectrum by Potentate Watercolors. This is something that I've been recommending most of my students. Like all my workshops, I keep recommending this to my students, especially in Hyderabad, because it's easily available in the stationery stores. It's a 300 GSM paper, really good quality for beginners, and it's not very expensive. It's very affordable. This one is an old journal. I don't know where I got this, how I got this. It's been there with me for a while. I've been using it for some rough sketches and watercolors and stuff like that, but I didn't really use it so much. Quality is okay, it's not of a great quality, but yeah. This one here is from Moleskine. I've been looking for this one everywhere, in every place I traveled, every airport, wherever I can, and I finally found it in some place. I don't really remember right now, but yeah, I hope to finish this one. I really want to fill this, but I really don't have the time to do it. Maybe when in my next travel, I'll try to finish this one. This one is from Canson, and I use this mostly for my watercolor journaling during my travels. And it's of great quality. The next few are mostly for my professional purpose only, the ones which I use for my art projects. This one's from Arches, a 300 GSM paper, amazing quality. It's a cold press paper, and I have few others with a similar kind of quality that I use only for my art projects. You must have seen them on my gram and other pages. So that's pretty much it, guys. That's all the watercolor collection that I have, with papers and brushes and the paints. All that I have are all on this video. I hope you liked it and enjoyed it. Until next time.